Hello and welcome to the episode 102 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we have an 8-hour marathon, Paul creating the basic plan for Magical Mystery Tour, and George and John leaving Rishikesh. Let's begin with the 12th of April 1961 and with the usual top 10 club night for the Beatles with Pete Best on drums. The night-long performance was part of the band's second West Germany residency. And it was for the start of the lads' third Hamburg residency that manager Brian Epstein and George Harrison flew from Liverpool to Hamburg 1 year later, on the 12th of April 1962. The other Beatles had already landed in Hamburg the day before, but George had to defer his trip due to an illness. In 1963, the Beatles returned at the Cavern Club to head the 8-hour A Shot of Rhythm and Blues Marathon No. 2. The event also featured the Foremost, the Denisons, the Nomads, the Panthers, the Flintstones, the Roadrunners, Group 1, and Farren's Flamingos. This was the penultimate time the Beatles appeared at the Cavern. On the 12th of April 1964, the Beatles were back at the Marylebone Station in London with the A Hard Day's Night crew to shoot more details for the opening sequence. This time, there were no fans present, and with the station closed off as every Sunday, the work could proceed more at ease. More filming in 1965, this time for Help or Eight Arms to Hold You, as the film was still called at the time. The Fabs were at the Twickenham Film Studios to work on a scene seemingly taking place inside Buckingham Palace, in which they faced Professor Foote's relativity cadenza. Also today, during a meeting between BBC radio executives and Brian Epstein, Epstein promised that the Beatles would have appeared in more bank holiday specials. Specifically, there was a verbal agreement for something to air on the 7th of June, the 30th of August, and the 26th of December. However, Epstein was not able to keep his word. While a special was indeed recorded for the 7th of June, despite a general lack of enthusiasm from the band, Epstein was only able to offer interviews and other material to put together a 45-minute documentary for the 30th of August, and nothing at all for the 26th of December. This, if anything else, was a sign that the four had outgrown the desire or the need to appear on the media, even on BBC. 2 years later, in 1967, Paul McCartney returned from his United States holiday with Beatles assistant Mal Evans. According to Beatles historian Mark Lewson, during the flight back to London, McCartney jotted down his initial idea for the Magical Mystery Tour project, a TV special and an album about a mystery tour of England on a bus. He had the tentative structure of the show, with a circle representing the 60 minutes of a TV special divided in 8 segments, each featuring a very basic idea like recruiting, lunch, dreams, or hire coach. When the plane landed, though, Paul had to dismiss the ongoing rumors of the certain demise of the Beatles with the journalists that greeted him. Paul commented, "The Beatles are definitely not splitting up. We have never even thought of splitting up. We want to go on recording together. The Beatles live." Paul eventually talked about his Magical Mystery Tour idea to the rest of the band, and after some discussion, as we will see, they decided to go ahead with it. Finally, on this day in 1968, George Harrison and John Lennon decided to leave Rishikesh and the Transcendental Meditation Studies with Maharishi Mahesh Yogi. The reasons for their departure are not totally clear. George Harrison maintains that he had always planned to leave the camp at a given time. From the anthology book, "Ringo only went for a couple of weeks, maybe just to put his toe in the water and see what it was like. Paul just came and went. I don't think he got much out of the trip." The idea of the course was that it lasted however many weeks in Rishikesh, and then, at the end of that period, they shifted the camp up to Kashmir. This was something they did every year, but I'd planned to go just for the Rishikesh trip and then go down to the south of India to do some filming with Ravi Shankar. I kept telling Maharishi, no, I'm not going to Kashmir. I told him I was going south, and that's when John and I left. I think John wanted to get back because he had just started his relationship with Yoko before we went out to India. On the other hand, John Lennon also seemed to be upset about allegations that Maharishi had misbehaved with one young woman of the camp, perhaps a number of women, maybe including Mia Farrow. The allegations were reported to John by his friend, Magic Alex Mardas. Years later, Cynthia Lennon remembered in her book John, I had seen Alex with a girl who was young and impressionable, and I wondered whether he, whom I had never once seen meditating, was being rather mischievous. I was surprised that John and George had both chosen to believe him. It was only when John and I talked later that he told me he had begun to feel disenchanted with the Maharishi's behavior. He felt that, for a spiritual man, the Maharishi had too much interest in public recognition, celebrities, and money. John and George confronted Maharishi with Lennon flatly stating that they were leaving. When asked why by Maharishi, John simply replied, "If you're so cosmic, you should know." As the preparation for their trip to Delhi was underway, John Lennon started to write Sexy Sadie, initially called Maharishi, a song used to vent off his feelings about the whole situation. In a taxi trip to Delhi, John sang the song to George, who suggested to change the title to Sexy Sadie to avoid any diplomatic incident, so to speak. The Lennons and Mardas managed to catch an overnight flight to London. George Harrison, his wife Patty, and her sister Jenny decided to stay in Mardas for some time at Ravi Shankar's. And with this story, we can conclude today's episode of What a Fab Day. If you like my work so far and fancy doing something to make me feel less alone, please consider visiting www.simonmas.com/support. There are many things you can do to show me how fab you are, including simply dropping me a line or telling all of your friends and enemies about this very podcast. Tomorrow, we'll have the Beatles' debut on BBC. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation. Simon Mas, music you love.